Guten Abend, sehr verehrtes Publikum und herzlich willkommen zum heutigen Currensis Lab. Wenn Sie unsere Meldungen aufmerksam verfolgt haben, dann werden Sie alle wissen, dass dies die letzte Saison unseres Chefdirigenten ist und es sich heute Abend damit auch tatsächlich um das letzte Currensis Lab überhaupt handelt. Im Fokus allerdings des heutigen Labs steht die Schostakowitsch-Symphonie Nummer 13. Und hier, wo ich jetzt gerade stehe, hätte heute Abend eigentlich unser Solist Alexander Winogradow stehen sollen und natürlich auch singen sollen. Damit aber tatsächlich er komplett fit für die bevorstehenden Konzerte ist, hat er es sich erbeten, heute Abend eine kleine Auszeit zur vollen Genesung zu nehmen. Und somit werden Sie aber heute Abend im heutigen Currensis Lab den estnischen nationalen Männerchor natürlich gemeinsam mit Ihrem SWR-Symphonieorchester unter der Leitung von Theodor Currensis erleben. Und daher wünsche ich Ihnen jetzt einen musikalisch aufschlussreichen Abend bei allem, was jetzt kommt. Vielen Dank.
I think the things that we can find in rehearsals are the things that we will never find in a concert. In the way that a concert is a presentation, and you have a lot of pluses. Everybody is like very careful, everybody is very motivated. So you always have more energy. If you see the diagram of the computer recording, you will see that the concert, the diagram is fatter than the rehearsal diagram. So they play louder, the forte is louder, the piano is softer, all the contrasts are bigger in the concert because the people want to present this. But the discovery, it is in the rehearsal time. So what I'm trying to do in the concert, actually I open my secret. In the concert, I try to make everything that we agreed with the orchestra in a spontaneous way, that we have also the flash of the spontaneous, of the discovery. That's what it is missing. If the orchestra would be possible that they will come to the concert and they will do exactly what we agreed, as we agreed in the dynamic that we see, in the intonation that we did and everything, that would be very boring. Also, the fact that every concert, there's not a single concert in the history of humanity that it is perfect. Because you have to make with the lack of the defect of and the accidental part of the mankind. What that means that when we have 120 people, 140 people, the moment that someone of them will make a mistake, will not fall in the right note, will not be in a completely different rhythm. This is something necessary. If we can imagine that the orchestra will never have an accident in the concert, will never have a problem, will never have something like this, then it would be a computer, would be a horrible, nasty performance. So our perfection in our lives is the imperfection. You fly with the airplane and you see a land down and you see that it's very squared geometrically. You see squares and squares and it's all clean and sterilized. And when you land down, you go to this land, you see a lot of insects, it is not perfect, all this, nothing special. But this is the imperfection in another perception. This gives the true perfection. That's why it is important that the orchestra is collaboration of many different people, different characters, and has not been discovered a big instrument that one man plays and creates the sound of the orchestra. Because then you don't have, orchestra is actually minds and souls together. Orchestra is not a bunch of professionals. It's a collective, it's the Noah's Ark of different sacred minds that have to be saved in the cataclysm of the historical time. Because as we know history, it is the only thing that we are sure in this history of the mankind, it is about the catastrophe, destruction, and cataclysm. That's the only sure. But we are a part of unwritten symphony and unwritten history. That means in the official history, this collection of the souls and minds never take places. We talk about theology, we talk about philosophy when we want to speak about the important things. When we want to talk about imperfection, destruction, and war, we talk exactly about the written history, that everyone has his own truth and his own failure. So we are here in two words, to share our imperfection than to achieve the perfection. To know deeper our imperfection and to share and showing compassion to one to the imperfection of the other, this is what it is. The music that cures, the music that heals, and not the music for the elevator and for the jacuzzi. So, we start with the sad music, with the first movement. Okay.
Okay. What did this, what Shostakovich writes this symphony the same period with Britain's War Requiem?
In British music, it's a kind of amazing ceremonial music for the Coventry Cathedral, and has been performed half a year after the Babi Yar, in May, and Babi Yar is just before this year, of the performance of the War Requiem. Shostakovich, for my opinion, creates also a type of requiem, but with a blasphemy. Let's say a blasphemial requiem. And he talks about forgotten things, because all these things that Yevtushenko is talking here, we are forgetting. How he creates that? Actually, we have a bass line that could be a Bach or something like this. Can you play this bass line in a fast tempo? Look, funny. Three, and. So this can be a folk Russian song, but also can be a bass from Baroque music. What it is in this slow, around 60, quarter equal to 60 tempo, what it is very important to feel that we are in a kind of catacomb, that there is no light. We have corridors and corridors and corridors and darkness. So there is not light on that. For that, to create this atmosphere, the wind instruments that play the melody should feel themselves like a resonance from the pizzicato of the Chilean basses. So this line of the should be a little softer, of the bassoon and bass clarinet, and the pizzicato should be really precise and scary, without a lot of nuance. Just following this corridor on this, in the catacombs of the history of the mankind. Then we have this melody, the other part, that is the horns and the trumpets, that with the sordino, as is written, they create a strange register of the orgel. So if it would be balanced, you will listen a kind of organ sound, but at the same time, you will listen the sound of the old tube radio that opens and has a kind of Soviet jazz music. You know, Shostakovich did a jazz suite, and there was the so-kind Soviet jazz. So it is a kind of a deja vu between these two different worlds, the organ, the catacomb, and something from this jazz music. Listen, interesting how sounds the horns with the trumpets. Three and four and one and two. Nice. Nice. Let's listen together with the bass now, this. Okay. It's very nice, so you see this image. What I would like now to ask, the basses with the cello is fine. The bass is a little softer than the pizzicato. Because I listen to you not blended with the rest of the group. The trumpets with the horns, if it's possible not to have an accent in the first 16 notes, so we don't have ta-da-da-da, but to have ro-ra-ra-dee, ro-ra-ra-dee.
Sounds like boom, boom, ta da da da. Can you do this without the pizzicato one? 3, 4, 1, 2. But together, si da 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 di wa wa di. 3, 1, 2. After this is written by Shostakovich, tenuto. I would like to give a shape to this tenuto, not to be tom, bom, 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 to be like boom, 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 boom. And then I ask you to make a little espressivo. This crescendo that you're doing is too much from the horns. Less, because the organ, as you understand, doesn't have a lot of nuance. They don't have nuance. So this is shouldn't be out noticeable like a printed crescendo diminuendo. It should be inside in the cell of the phrase. With the cello and the bass is the beginning. Three, and I think it's great. I think it's great now, the things. The only problem that I see in the phrase and little disturbs me to get in this meditation and this narrow corridor, it is the fact that we start with a little accent of the bassoon. I listened too much to the bassoon in the beginning. And then when we have 8 notes, the metronome is not equal. Boom, boom. The second beat comes too early and then boom. Boom, boom, boom. These 8 notes are a little rushy. It should be boom, 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 boom. You see, the second beat is rushing. Somebody rush for in the second beat. Good. We can do more balanced. And count the 16 notes before to make it perfect. You see, most of the orchestras, they play, because it's written forte, they play not balanced and not together with this very difficult beginning, in fact. This sounds like, sounds like more equal. Can we have tam tam ti da dam ba da din bam bam? This place with the horns, you watch how important it is to blend the horns with the oboes, very difficult blending. Play, please, bar six. And only, can I listen on the horns? And yes, inside the slur, in the 8 notes, you need a little to separate the 8 notes. wah, 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 okay? And one. Now, the clarinets with the oboes, without the horns, and the one. Intonation. One. Little louder the clarinets, together with the horns and the pizzicato, everybody six. And the intonation, the horns. Together, and the one. See now, this very beautiful what you're doing, and I like the yaram, the accent that you're doing there, but after that, it's like the phrase stops. I need a continuation. I need a kind of long phrase and long flow of the breath. Is what you're doing. Can we adjust the chorus? One, two, three. For me, it is important to connect. Not. Okay? One, two, not. Great. Now, pamitnik afnet, if you can give a little direction to the phrase, not pamitnik afnet, but pamitnik afnet, pamitnik afnet. And not babim ya. These three notes with emotion. One, two, three, and not. I love the way you see what Yevtushenko plays with the R. Крутоя бревна, грубое над гробе. Yes, it is really horrible. They say there are no monuments in Babi Yar. And it should be scary. So that if you roll the R, but you don't make it terribly shocking, then is it. Крутоя бревна, грубое над гроб. Крутоя бревна, грубое над гроб. Has to be with the emotion together. Okay? One more time. One, two, three. And not. Beautiful. If you, the brief. This note, continue this note, don't release it. One, two, three. That's it. That's it. Okay. Then the orchestra, I want the orchestra with the espressivo to be terrifying. They say, I'm terrified. Mi strash. Mi strash. And this starts in bar 19. So I would like to hear only the orchestra from bar 19. You do crescendo, I want intensity. This is very disciplined. Okay, I start the crescendo when it's written, but before that, if there is no intensity, the crescendo is empty. It is just dynamic, it's louder. I said, I'm scared, I'm so old as the Jewish people. So it is these words, right? I'm trying to translate well the music, but this, you need to feel this intensity. If you don't feel this intensity, it is just a crescendo, it's empty crescendo. One, two, three. I have five more steps, and you finished. The crescendo has to be really till the horns. Entrance. One, two, in the. Oh man. Intensity. So the chorus also should be, the crescendo has to be really, really, really slow, slow intensity, and then the crescendo. It's the intensity that brings the crescendo, the dynamical crescendo. It's not the crescendo that will bring the quality, the intensity. Now, these Jewish tunes, you need to feel the pain and the blood that there is inside. On that. You know, the down, up. It's not that. So, let's go one, cipher one. We do all the whole phrase. One, two, three. Scared. Little more drama in the eighth notes. That is more drama. And then they have to be in the same articulation in the trumpets that there is in the horns. Okay? Now, I had the phrase with a great crescendo. Now, if we will try to feel from the beginning of the chorus till the end of the phrase, that it is one phrase, that we do a lot of things, but we still keep going in this corridor, that would be fantastic. We do one last time the same place. One, two, three. Okay, great. That is good. Can we take five, please? We go to the second episode. Five. Now, I would like to ask one thing. When you come back to the Tempo Primo should be precise in the basis as it is in the Pizzicato. The arco is always more late than the Pizzicato. We know that, right? Avoid that. It should be really metronomical, same tempo with the beginning. Now, the pizzicato and the tuba in the beginning, boom, 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 they have to give always the feeling of the tempo. No, it's boom, 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 and this has to be like a Tommy gun. Not beautiful. Beauty here is that it should be not beautiful. Chorus. Krof, blut. The T in the blut is the V in the krof. It is, you see, with the distant tat tat tat, this blood. So it is, it should be super scary, aggressive and scary. And then, Lotsarastikaias, Lotsarastikaias, should be not Lotsarastikaias, papa. In the end. Only that, you see, they shouldn't, the people that they don't know the text, they shouldn't think, oh, they play a kind of weird polka. But they are, it is, they play in an aggressive way because the other likes the contrasts. So they need to understand if we talk about death. We talk about slaughter. We talk about the most horrible things here with this music, the music of the happiness of this world. So that's the contrast, and that's the super ugliness that gives a spiritual beauty. It's like the Goya caprichos that you see, and it's horrible, but that's why it is beautiful, because it's so horrible. Okay, five. Pizzicato in time, please. One and two and... It is great. I think it's great. I just this dirty pizzicato in the jazz bar. Dum, 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 dum. The basses. Can you please give me more of this? Let's listen to the basses from 68, 69, 70. One, two, eight. I would make a little bim bam bim bam bim bam bam bam, a little accents. One, two, one. Same. Okay, great. One last time from five. One and. Спасай Россию, shouting. And this, give me the strings, just this, only the strings. And one. But I need this to be like. It's an execution, it's not tarantella. And one. Okay. But go, God, beige. Okay. Seven. One. But go, even more bloody ta 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 ta. This has to be really this 20% of emotion, and to give everything in these five notes, six notes, it's actually what we're missing now. That everybody will give maximum in this. Okay, 103. No. Here it is when he said, they beating my mother. This is the pogrom. The future of this world, the pogrom. The past and the future of this world is pogrom, actually, in fact. We are living in another reality, but that's the truth. And I want the orchestra to show that like a protest. Please dance. They are killing my mother. They are raping my mother while you're dancing. So it has to be really horrible. I ask you to make head banging here. So in the orchestra. Okay? Can we just do this? Everybody moves one and. Streaked. It's a cold air in Babi Yar. It's very cold there. There's no this really, really straight equal. And also, Jürgen, is it possible before 9, 1, 2 bars before 9, immediately diminuendo. When you go in the half notes, hide a little bit to have more legato. Okay? From 9, please. Thank you. That was nice. I would like to go 19. Sorry, we can play a little before. Let's stay a little before. From 16. The bassoon is a little softer to blend with the pizzicato. A little softer. La Major said the breaking the door. In this note, La Major. No, La Major. Keep the intensity. Don't fall in the La Major. Okay? Keep the intensity. Okay, from fortissimo, 19. Re and
Major.
Okay. When you say Dvier, give me fear. They come to take you. La Major! Mr. B. No, dear. Who is that? Oh, we have a party. Are my guests here? It's not that. La Major, it's something else. 1, 2. Okay, together. Together, together, 19. And.
La Major!
Это ледоход. Here I would like you to go horizontal. The most horizontal you go, what I mean horizontal, what is vertical? Horizontal. Sawing the teeth while you're doing this tenuto. Painful tenuto. Not vertical. Horizontal. Pesante, largamente. 3 before 20, please. 1 and thank you. The skeletons are playing. The good professionals are playing. Here we are not professionals, we are skeletons. That's why we need to. And everybody, if I don't see sweat, veins in the face, in all the players, then I don't have what I want. I don't want the fortissimo. I don't want fortissimo. I don't want staccato. I want this. This. And what I don't want. This I don't want. Okay, 20 little faster. 1, 20 straight. 3, and. Armageddon and the explosion of the explosions. 1, 2. Here I want the string group to be ready to give full power, con tutta forza. Listen when they play the strings, why I'm saying that. For Shostakovich, the fascism comes with the Valkyrie. Listen now, the ride of Valkyrie in 21. Strings, please, and woodwinds. 3, and. Good, good. The trillo. Scary without scary appoggiatura. Okay? All together from 21. And good splash with Tam Tam and Gran Casa. With me? And. I want that you will start with the bells up. Ta da da da. Okay? 3, and. I saw you. I know that you will do a big crescendo. I saw you a little bit, this poco, poco crescendo. The brass, softer with them. After this, I know it is after this fortissimo, it is very difficult to go in pianissimo, balanced pianissimo, but we need to blend them. Just one thing about the strings, so I will not forget, I always forget to tell you. 2 before 22, I want you, when you make this tremolo, to go closer in the crescendo to talone and to finish here. Okay? Let's go. From 25. Why I take this? Because I want you to listen the harp. Listen the harp. You are the resonance of the harp. How soft has to be lightened to be the resonance. And softer viola. Più piano, listen the harp. Softer cello basses. Little soft. Too much. Why? Why? This is the question. Okay, it is my last lab, but I want to leave something to you. What I want to leave, it is logic. We are in the dead field, right? We are shadows. We are, I don't know. And you see a crescendo espressivo, and immediately from this haunted place, you make a crescendo with a very healthy sound because you have crescendo. He doesn't write dynamic, so you need to calculate how much this crescendo has to be. What is important? The drama of the music and the really compassion to the idea of music, or to make a beautiful crescendo with our famous good instruments. So what is the goal here? So you know everything. I know. I don't tell you what to do. I just think, just put logic, okay? 26, please. 3, and 1, 2, and 1.
Thank you.
here he writes piumoso, poco piumoso. And I want this remembrance of the Fifth Symphony, of the Eighth Symphony, that it is the two groups in with the motifs in conversation. Bam, ta-di, bam, ta-da, tam, ta-di, bam, ba-bam, tam, ta-dim, tam, ta-di, no, tam, ta-di, tam, tam, ta-da, ba, ta-da, ba, ta-da. With this energy, not bam, ba-di. It's not a marcionette. That's why he writes piumoso also. Okay, 27, please. Three, and one, hey. Please. Keep the long note with the guts. Bum, da-di. Keep this, not da-di, don't release. Three, and one, hey. So, this is kind of the degrees that we need to make this music so it will not be a reproduction of an idea, but to be flesh and blood of the idea. We need to defend the idea of this if we want to play this music. You know, this is a repertoire that I play very rare, because in these degrees, it is very heavy to get in and get out. So, I mean, it is very bad for the health. Let's say that. But it is necessary, like the antibiotics, you know? The antibiotics is also bad for the health, but sometimes helps. And the last 3,000 years, we need this kind of catharsis, we need this kind of high dose of drama to get relieved and to let it go after this. And if we go to perform the tragedies of Aeschylus, of Sophocles, of Euripides, and the drama is not working, then it is artificial literature. It's like the joke, they say, the conciliums of the doctor after the operation. The doctor say, the operation was successful, and the patient died. So it's a little bit like that, drama without catharsis. So thank you very much. Have a very nice evening, everybody. Thank you for the company. And see you tomorrow. We have much work to do in the third movement. Bye-bye.